Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna see how to make our own paper texture by just taking a normal paper and then crumble it and then take a picture of it using your smartphone, and then we're gonna use it on Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then I will go and open an image that we'll be using. Alright, now we'll go back and open one of the pictures that I took, which is just like an A4 white paper that I crumbled, and then I straightened up and I took a picture of it. Now you can add like crayon, wax crayon or whatever, make it dirty with the dirt, and then you will have some interesting texture to the whole thing. But for this video, I will keep it like this. All right, I think I'm happy with that. Now, we can actually make a copy of this because I want to use the shadows and the highlights of this texture. So let's actually name this highlight. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J and let's name this shadow. All right, now we'll make the shadow one invisible and I will select highlight. Now, we want to bring out the highlight of this paper, and to do that we're gonna choose one of the highlight blending mode, which is lighten screen to lighter color. I will go for screen, and as you can see it is a little bit too bright for this image, so I will apply a level adjustment and then I will clip it to the texture, and then I'm gonna play with the midtones of this until I will see a perfect spot for the highlights of the texture. As you can see, there are those ones in here. I'm more focusing on the lip area because I think it makes a big difference. So I think somewhere around this range, it looks really interesting. Yeah, I think I like this. All right, now we can add more adjustment to this. For example, you can go and apply, let's see, brightness and contrast and clip it. And then you can play with the contrast a little bit and maybe take down the brightness a little bit. And this will make it blend even better, as you can see. And then you can always go back and remove any of this if you want. But I think it looks really cool. Now we'll make the shadow texture visible. And then I will change the blending mode of it to the darken blending modes. I will go with multiply. And then I will go and apply another level. I will clip it. And again, I will play with the midtones and the shadows and highlight of it. So I want to focus on the shadows of the textures, which is this one's in here. So it depends on how strong you want them to be. So for example, for me, I don't want them to be that dark. As you can see, this is too much. So I will just try to keep them blend better basically with the image. Yeah, I think somewhere around this range, it looks really interesting. Perfect. Now I'm gonna group everything together by pressing shift and one click on the highlights, and then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command G and let's call this texture. Now we have our texture folder on top. Now we can go ahead and apply like maybe a text, another image below it, and it will be applied the same texture. So for example, I will go and maybe I will apply a text. Let's see, maybe we can type something like hyper or power. And then I will make it smaller, something like this, and maybe a little bit more smaller than that. And let's place it just right here. And let's actually make the letter P bigger. So I will select it and I will make it bigger around this range in here. I think it will be really interesting like this. but I don't like this space that we have between the P and the O. So I will select the text and I will just one click like this, and I'm gonna press Alt or Option, and I will go to the left using my arrow key, and this will basically remove this space, and let's actually place this again around here. Alright, it looks really cool. Now I want to change this text color to maybe this. Yeah, I think it looks really cool like that. And maybe let's actually remove a part of the P. So I will apply a layer mask, and I will use a brush, and I will start deleting in this area just like that to make it more interesting. All right, so as you can see, this is our paper texture. So we created this using our paper, and as you can see, it looks a really nice poster. So this is before and this is after. All right, so I hope that you enjoy and do like this quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.